Frank has introduced himself, the president of Velocity Technology Partners, and he is an expert at finding technologies in one domain and bringing them into healthcare. It's an incredible skill, and he is going to talk to us about those of you who see the title. COTS stands for commercial off the shelf. So stuff you can buy, gadgets that would be useful for promoting health. Right?
Thank you, Mark. Well, I had the pleasure of meeting Mark and Jeff at a TTI Vanguard conference out in Ritz-Carlton in D.C. A couple months ago. And we chit-chatted about life as we know it. And I glommed on the fact that I'm in the presence of innovators. And there's nothing that impresses innovators more than innovation. It's the ability to go ahead and do aha with something that already exists. I practice not inventing, all right? Say that again. I don't make anything, all right? But I figure out what everybody else has made and how to apply it into new use cases. For me, that's innovation. Figuring out how to make our lives better and come up with something better all the time. Now, what I'm gonna share with you today are, and I'm gonna go, this is a Reader's Digest condensed version. I'm not gonna hit every one of these companies. My God, we'll be here all day. I'm going to cover what I think is key, the things that I find novel on each of these pages. And more importantly, they're very low risk because they already exist or are precipitating in the market here very shortly. Some of them you may have heard of, some of them I hope you haven't. But by and large, I'm a solutioneer. I look for how to deal with solutions, to come up with something. In particular, I support Special Operations Command and the Defense Department. And believe me, they keep me busy, particularly if you read the front pages of the paper anytime lately. I want to share with you that I have no pony in the pile of any of these companies. I could care less. I won't say that outright. Because I do have along one of the vendors, Right Eye, who has an integrated capability for being able to do eye tracking, which is pretty bizarre. Soon to hit the market, and it is primarily a concussion testing system and can be used for a number of other things involving eye therapies and brain recognition. So without further ado, I don't have a vested interest in any of the companies that I'm sharing with you, and by large, it's an XYZ coordinate inside of a box. There are others that oscillate around that point. I'm trying to stretch your imagination into some of the areas that I think are key to the future of healthcare and where there are technologies that play out now, where you might look at a commercial platform as being key to how you do your work and your future. Okay, let me see, right click. Mark loves quotes. I'm gonna pull four of my own. The first one relates to the fact that we live in a requirements world which is unsatisfying and ungratifying. If I constantly look at how to meet a requirement, I will never get ahead, all right? No one knows what the art of the possible is. On my defense customer side, I spend all of my day showing them YouTube videos and bringing forward stuff that they don't know. If you want another horse, you'll get another horse. Believe me, there was not a requirements document for a Model T. By the way, we're not getting any richer. So coming up with ways to leverage commercial capabilities and develop what I'll call mutations or transformational Legos is a big deal. We're not getting any safer. And last but not least, we live in a world of improvisation, and sometimes good enough is figuring out how to use a ballpoint pen spring, duct tape, and a paperclip. Okay. Many of you have seen the Gartner Research Hype Cycle. It was developed in 2008. Basically highlights the technologies that are out there, pretty much that are still out there now. My trick is to figure out what's inside this red box that is going to reach the slope of enlightenment. All right. Here's where we are. Here's where we want to be. And by the way, all of this has to go through a death valley called a trough of disillusionment. So where do the things that make sense pop out the other side and become successful? In the health sciences, particularly related to COTS technologies, I kind of outlined a domain space that's tangential to what you do. And these key mission areas, I think, are driving a major influence over everything that you're going to see in the future of healthcare, short and long term. Mobility is driving a lot of things. Remote sensors, small processors. Sport fitness and wellness is, oh my gosh, I mean, the stuff you can do in your home now is phenomenal. Robotics, genomics, thank you, optogenetics, new materials and practices, microsensors and processors, which are smaller than, I mean, I can stack 200 of them on a dime right now and do some remarkable things. And I think here's some of the places where those play out. I think you're going to see more edge services in the home. Golden hour triage, I think, is going to change dramatically. Rapid sensing and MRSA control kinds of things, disruptive treatment protocols, disease, handicap, and rehab support, lab analysis training and stuff. So I'll talk to you a little bit about the lab piece. There's DNA sequencers now that you can hold in your hand. All right, machine to machine and Internet of Things. Everybody may have seen this slide, maybe not. It's being from Beecham Research. You are one of nine domains of the future. Between now and 2021, there will be 2.5 billion remote sensors coming out. 2.5 billion. In healthcare, it boils itself into telemedicine, pumps, monitors, implants, MPIs, PDAs, hospital ER, this area here. That's your sweet spot. Nobody's going to touch you on that, but all these other guys are out there doing stuff too. So 2.5 billion devices in progress right now. In fact, there's a company in the UK right now that will sell you 15,000 edge devices, a router, and an integrated server. All comes in a box, Visa, MasterCard accepted. So I can literally wire a complete hospital system, or for that matter, Washington, D.C., wirelessly overnight in unlicensed spectrum. Already exists. So what are some of these fun things? Let me highlight one that's close to home. Not real close, but close. It's in Western Virginia and West Virginia. 380 smart ambulances that are out there. Each one of them has a secure cloud service on board, HIPAA compliant, multi-level. All of the healthcare files, electronic files from six regional medical centers are in each ambulance. The TMTs know everything that a doctor does. They know the last time you had a lab test, they know what meds you're on, they know what your vitals are supposed to be, they know your insurance card, they know everything about you. When an ambulance rolls up on site in one of these six hospitals, nothing is said because the ambulance knows everything the hospital does, the hospital knows everything the ambulance does. Pretty remarkable program. All of it goes off of integrated Android apps, all secure. And over the Androids, they can do radio over IP. They can do push-to-talk radios, brick phones. They can do SOS and Blue Force tracking at 1 second. And cameras, secure voice and data, and integrated SATCOM, if so choose. All off of a device that's about the size of a Burger King box or a McDonald's box underneath the driver's seat. Four cameras on board, integrated pan, tilt, zoom. Wave 2 router, the stuff that we're doing right now in Wi-Fi is Cro-Magnon. This is pretty state-of-the-art here. We're up now to 2 times the range and up to probably 6 times the capacity. That's out there right now. I mean, literally, it's a plug and replace to go ahead and do up to 500 users with these kind of data rates at twice the range, otherwise known as a hospital. The brain, one of my favorite topics. OBE, oh, by the way, a lot of the stuff I pick up is through consumer electronics shows in Vegas, CE Week conferences up in New York. Some of the mHealth stuff, I go to those, but by and large, it's what goes on in Consumer Electronics Show in the health and fitness area, and a reciprocal program up in New York. And in addition, in my government office, there's probably 3 to 10 companies a week that come in, and I play everything from Dear Abby to Shark Tank. I've seen it all, heard it all. 16-channel CT scanner, cerebral mapping, non-invasive real-time, it's out there now. This one right here, linear dimensions, 7x7x2 centimeters, does all of these functions, plus printouts and downloads onto an Android or an iPhone. Special Ops right now uses this in air ambulances. They monitor all their patients en route and keep diagnostic information on every one of them. From a scene or from a hospital medevac. It's a plug-and-play device, monitors everything they do, limits the number of tubes and attachments. They're very happy with it. Spencer Transcranial is doing work in TBI, doing deep-level cranial blood flow analysis and resonance therapies, particularly for wounded warriors. Emotive, many of you have seen that, the integrated neurofeedback system. 14-channel EEG. At Consumer Electronics Show, I powered a car by watching it off of my brainwaves. This guy right here, the Interaxon Muse, pretty straightforward, but a lot of information that you can get off of this thing on doing EEG analysis of yourself. I call it the technical yoga device. And you can get it on Amazon for under $200. And Barbara will testify to the fact that it certainly knows when you're nervous or not. So she just did an EEG test earlier. I'd be happy to let anybody try it if they want off of my Android. Key thing is that you can have one of these in your office and have everybody use it off the same app. So you have one device and everybody can download the app. Helmet technology, very important, not necessarily for this group, but for the people that deal in everything from pro football to getting their heads blown off. Some interesting developments taking place in acoustic foams, in different kinds of ballistic protection and polycarbonate inflated liners. This is applying the process in reverse. I'm using ECGs in order to determine my password. So I can take my electrocardiogram signature and use it as my sign-on for a computer. Finger mouse is coming out. Finger mouse is applied to your iPhones and Androids primarily for being able to navigate screens without using touchpads. So you can use your finger to move around on a screen rather than trying to go ahead with my big fat fingers being able to do anything on a screen. For the future MD, you'll have a projection screen on your arm off of a bracelet that's coming out right now. So it's a pickup projector and it lets you go ahead and do your work right on your hand. Digital insoles for measuring both your pace rate as well as providing temperature settings for the people that freeze. Number of nano electronic clothing that are coming out. There's an e-t-shirt right now at the University of Arkansas where the National Nano Center is. They're doing some remarkable work in being able to do EEG readings and work in this area. This is a Cambridge set here that's used by the Olympians for being able to determine strokes by the way emissions radiate off your body when fabric is stretched. And Thalmic Labs is a gesture control system. This is a series of accelerometers inside of a bracelet with a 4K microprocessor inside. So however I move results in a displacement, which equates to a command. So I can do everything from flying a quadcopter to turning a wheelchair 360 degrees to anything else in between by using gestures. I think that's a unique science that needs to be thought through a little more with regard to the handicapped and the disabled in some fashion or another. That's in its infancy, believe me. I have the privilege of having Barbara here with RightEye. Their device and system allows for crowd scanning, target detection, hand-eye coordination, multivisual task and concussion testing and head trauma recovery. And by and large, the concussion testing activity equates to, this is a demo test activity that shows what can happen with respect to measuring your neurovision and the controls for it. So we'll leave this up for anyone afterwards or at the end of the session to look at the neural eye activities. Graphene sensors, by going across a graphene trough, you can pick up molecules. As you radiate energy through this, the molecules change the microvoltages that go across it. Therefore, I can determine the content of different kinds of things that are out there, including bad molecules and pathogens. So it's a sensor using graphene. Oxford Technology Minion, one of my favorites. Single molecule nanopolar DNA tester. Doing some work with the University of North Carolina at Charlotte with this right now on some research for the CDC. Consumer Physics SIO is a handheld photoelectric materials analysis and characterization tool. So it does optical testing of any material. And basically, in intrigue, I will tell you that the pharmaceutical community is all over this. Pfizer and others are big on this, because they can characterize their samples versus a generic, and they can determine content and validity of their drug samples by using optical stereoscopic techniques. By the way, you can tell everything out to, including the percent alcohol in a drink and the freshness of fruit. And it characterizes that information. I now have Defense Threat Reduction Agency involved in this thing, the FBI for forensics on blood samples and tissue samples, and a host of other things. We did some simple tests between anthrax and aspirin and those kinds of things. That's all going to be old business here pretty soon. Microscreen Systems BlinkSight, interesting program for doing tracking when there's no GPS. So this needs to go into Mark's pocket so you can find him, all right? Because you can find people with this in buildings, in big buildings, in complex environments. You can find them off of a device this size. TBT Group does advanced piezoelectric thin film materials with cantilevers. Those cantilevers pick up pathogen protein deposits in different ways. And the same way that I apply energy through here, if I apply it through a thin film, I get different resonance. And with different resonance, I determine different things that you have non-invasively off of tongue samples, water samples, blood serum samples. And that's pretty cool. Spinal body sensors is the top and bottom sensor that allow you to go ahead and do spine and hip recovery and core strength work. And it gives you, like you can go on a ski slope, a tennis court, a number of other things, lets you do that in short order. Seek infrared lets you do night vision off of an Android or an iPhone on a plug and play. Ironically enough, we use that to test a number of cases of people coming in that were sick recently through airports. So I could do a body scan of this in the room and just go, oops, I think you have a fever, right? And this is a pretty cool little thing. So it can be used a number of different ways. And UCLA has a single strand DNA analyzer for smartphones. This analyzer is a 3D printed device. So that's where we are on that domain. Some academic high nails, three of my favorites. First one is Worcester Polytechnic Institute. It has a non-metallic surgical robot that operates inside of an MRI. And using the MRI mechatronics, it currently does prostate surgery. So it takes the data off of an MRI that's used to control a robotic arm to implement prostate surgery inside of an MRI chamber. University of Virginia has a focused ultrasound system, 100 to 300 beam steerable phased array. Non-invasive ultrasounds being used in a number of clinical trials right now as we speak, involving brain and breast tumors, Parkinson's disease, and tremor management. And in the future, they're working epilepsy, stroke, liver, pancreatic, and kidney tumors. And Columbia University, probably my favorite program called Epibone. Epibone, they take and do subtractive manufacturing, i.e. carving away of a bone sample to replace a bone that you've lost, either through an injury or an accident or degenerative disease. And they can use a cadaver, cow bone, pig bone, anything. And as long as the cell structure is intact, they put it in an incubation chamber. Then they add some secret fertilizer to it along with your stem cells. And over a period of 10 weeks, you have a bone that's yours that is a perfect fit to replace the one that you had. It is regrowing a bone using another structure from something else, but it's your cells. By the way, I asked them about, can you do a bone marrow bank with that? And they're going, we hadn't thought of that. But yeah, you probably could. So you could donate marrow to yourself and raise your own bones. When I was in the lab, most of the things that I saw, however, were cranial skull plates. They were basically doing a lot of skull plate replacements, primarily because the body won't reject it, and it's perfectly mitered in a pre-cut before the surgery ever occurs. So the skull plate is a perfect match and a perfect replacement device. Anywhere is a nitrogen oxide ampule driven system that allows you to do sterilization in the field. Pretty unique system, pretty cool. Right inside the Tyvek bag, it goes ahead and cleans the surgical instruments. For all you cardiologists that I saw put your hands up, if you haven't heard of the Parace Bionics Echoscope, this is one of many, but this one's kind of cool. It's received a number of cardiology awards, FDA approved EKG, a full suite of cardio functions on this device. It's a six-lead stethoscope. Not to be outdone is the Echo Core stethoscope out of UC Berkeley, which is basically a plug-and-play module that goes into any stethoscope that lets you go ahead and visualize, record, and play back and share heartbeats and sounds that's HIPAA-compliant if it goes on an Android or an iPhone. So the doctor can record, store, and measure your heart rate and your pulse off of the system itself. Digital Ally in Kansas City makes a smart mirror that allows you to go ahead and see multiple video feeds. It's primarily for ambulances, but it can be used in a number of different environments. Gives you television monitors inside of the glass, as well as microprocessors that store information. So the mirror is a smart mirror and detects and controls everything. Doppler Labs, the Ultra Earbuds, is a noise cancellation and enhancement system for Androids and iPhones. These are under $200. These are coming out to circumvent the outrageously priced audiology market devices that are out there right now. Rave reviews on the Doppler Labs system. Sproutling baby monitor sensor strips sold out the first day. They're completely redoing everything that they're doing right now because they can't make them fast enough. This is for baby monitoring in hospitals or daycares or anywhere else in between. It is so fast and responsive, and the app's integrated into everything. It is FDA approved, and it predicts movements as well as wake periods. Monitors almost everything off of an ankle strap. Aftershocks is a spin-out of special ops community for hearing impaired. It's basically leveraging bone conduction. So it's a bone conduction technology system that's now COTS. Instead of doing major implants or coming up with other things, there are ways around that right now. Second Sight Robotics has been around for a while, but along with their retinal implants and co-processing, you now have 20 degrees field of view for people with profound retinitis pigmentosa, and it is FDA approved. Bodyometrics, and this is for high-risk patients and what, but you can go on Amazon and buy it for $249 right now. gives you all the biofeedback and information you'd ever want, and then some, even some you don't want or that you don't want to see. Fluidigm Juno Desktop is a DNA lab off of 2.5 nanograms per microliter. You can get DNA samples of up to 9,216 data points in 3 hours off of a system that's, you see the size. Breezing does metabolic testing using colorimetry, and it ends up measuring the consumed oxygen and carbon dioxide rates and does a respiratory quotient to determine your metabolic consumption and your fats and carbohydrates. Bluetooth earpiece, clip and talk. That's this guy. Looks like a Bluetooth. It is a Bluetooth, but it's also all of these things. Heart rate, blood pressure, breath rate, respiratory rate, oxygen, calories, steps, distance, cadence, energy expenditure, metabolic rate, and health logs, all downloaded to your phone. Syndaver makes anatomically correct synthetic bodies in spades. These are frightening. If you go online and look at them, they're frightening. I'll say that again. TerraView TPS Spectra 3000, a company out of the UK that's doing terahertz imaging for a variety of sample cases in spectrometry. The resolution and capabilities for doing tumor analysis using terahertz frequencies is bizarre. It is very clean and very precise. Cuvero bacterial copper alloy, probably have had them in here, but they are doing a number of things for the government right now in being able to do quarantine chambers for the government using copper alloys and copper systems. Almost done. Suitable Electronics developed the smallest version down here, which was in Consumer Electronics Show last year. The reason why this is pretty cool is because you can network them. This one was in Las Vegas. There was a node in Mountain View, California, one in Rochester, New York, and one in Frankfurt, Germany. And they were all driving around doing their thing, and we are all in an integrated environment. InTouch Health develops the RP6 and the Vita telepresence robots. These are the two guys here. Lots of initial work done in Detroit General Hospital and in UCLA using robotic inpatient care. One would think that patients would not like it. They do, because they're seen on time. They're seen with proficiency. They are seen with earnest and endeavor from the joystick of the physician who's in his office with all of his references. And last but not least, if they need a prescription or anything else, there's an RN accompanying this thing. Doctor prints out a prescription, comes out of the robot, sign it, ready to go. Plus, the doctor isn't distracted. The robot keeps control of the situation. The Xenex robot room disinfection system uses high-intensity ultraviolet for MENSA, for all the diseases and bacteria and bacterial spores. And uses UVC energy to control that environment. A couple hospitals have these running around. They basically are doing this full time. They go from one room to the next, to the next, to the next, to the next, to the next. And in some hospitals, it has dropped their MRSA activities down by 97%. Emergency support, never like to think about it, but I always do. Humidity harvesting, pulling water out of the air. Pretty straightforward, simple to do. Waka Waka power. This is an ultraviolet or a photovoltaic panel. LED lights on the back. Pretty straightforward system. Speech trance allows you to do speech integrated translation off of a bracelet on your wrist, attached to an iPhone or a laptop in your backpack. So you don't need to have a big clomping thing out there or any other kind of thing. You can do that off of an edge device. and these are basically water and shelter. And last but not least, the Martin Jetpack has a program going on involving the MetaJumper. It's a concept that I actually gave them, and now there's 7 countries that are implementing a MetaJumper system right now, particularly for high-density urban environments. I can take off and land one of these things with an EMT faster than your blades will ever turn on a helicopter. And you'll be on the scene of an incident, including landing on a roof or at a major intersection where there's a major collision or at a scene. And the only thing I don't carry with this thing is a gurney and the ability to evac. But I do carry communications and medical bag, crash paddles, and oxygen. Maybe I don't even need to dispatch a helicopter. Okay, so something to think about. And I want to thank you guys for all you do. All right. And Barbara has some stuff at the end. I don't know if we got a couple seconds yet or a little bit of time.
How much? We could take a break and then pick it up after the break. Is that okay?
Yeah, I mean 5 minutes.
Okay.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Okay, perfect.
Thank you.
Right, well.